Oh. is born, unto us a son is given.
And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Angel of Almighty Counselor.
Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song,
for he hath done marvelous things.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
Those who lived in a land of deep darkness on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and laid in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they had seen this, they made known what they had been told them, what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Many churches around this time of year, especially on Christmas Eve, have Christmas fashions, ranging from just a few children in homemade costumes to a full-blown Hollywood-style production. I'm sure you can find some of those around here. The last church I served in Dallas held a Christmas pageant at the 5 o'clock p.m. service on Christmas Eve. And we usually had about 15 to 20 children. And most years, we had a real live baby to play the part of baby Jesus. And if we had a pageant tonight, we'd have a real live baby as well. Well, a few years ago, several of the adults thought we were being age discriminatory by limiting the participants to children. So they started coming to rehearsals and played the part of various larger animals. You know where I'm headed. One of my good friends is about 65 years old and who has this really weird, quirky sense of humor, designed a cow costume, an anatomically correct costume of a cow, I might add. playing a goat, which just fits her really, really well. She said to me last year, and she was parading around in her cow costume, "I just have to be a part of this story." Moo! According to the Gospel of Luke, which you heard read tonight, there were a lot of people who were a part of the story that first Christmas. There was the Roman Emperor Augustus, the Caesar, the governor, Quirinius, Mary, Joseph, and the shepherds. Matthew's Gospel throws in Herod, who is the notorious king of Judea, and a group of traveling wise men from somewhere in the Far East. When you look at it, it's quite an assortment of people. Emperors, kings, a peasant couple, and a contingent of low-wage earning farmhands. Now, if I had a place in this story, I'd rather see myself as one of the close friends of Mary and Joseph, who were there to help with the birth and to celebrate. Or I would want to be a kind neighbor who brought over the hot water and the cloths and the tea and some scones, perhaps. I'd even settle for a place as one of the shepherds working the late shift that night, who at least get to see the glory of God up close and personal. But here I am tonight, dressed up a lot fancier than a shepherd. And I'll go home tonight and I'll sleep on a warm pillow-top mattress. I wonder, had I been in Bethlehem on that night 2,000 years ago, would I have gone out of my way to be a part of that strange and wonderful story? Or would I have gone about my own business and missed the good news? The good news that a Savior has been born who is none other than the Messiah, the Christ, the Lord. Many missed it, you know. Augustus Caesar missed it. The big shot governor missed it. The religious leaders in Jerusalem missed out as well, as did most of the people who went on about their business that night. You know this. Many still miss it, don't they? I miss it at times, and I bet you do too. But brothers and sisters, if you want to hear the good news and be a part of the story, you are in the right place tonight. The angel said the good news is not just for the mighty, the rich, or the poor. It is for all people. It is for everyone. The good news that a Savior has been born is for all of us, for you, for me. Good news, a Savior is born. Our government cannot save us. Republicans, Democrats, Wall Street cannot save us. More guns, more armies can't save us. Our possessions, our education, and our sophistication cannot save us. Only that child, that little baby in whom the fullness of God dwells, can save us. Good news. And the good news this night gets even better, because the angel told the shepherds, "This will be a sign for you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths lying in a manger." So simple, so ordinary, but nevertheless a sign. A sign of God's love. A sign that God is with us, all of us. Now, we probably will not see a vision of a heavenly chorus tonight, well, unless you've had a little too much champagne. Most of us will not see a bright star shining in the east. But my brothers and sisters, God still gives us a sign. A sign that is just as simple and ordinary as a baby in a manger. He gives us a sign a sign that he came to save us, and a sign that we too, all of us, are part of the story. Amen. I invite you to stand and reaffirm your faith and discuss with us the
word of God. We believe one God, the Father, the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God.
Remain faithful to the mystery of the Word made flesh and live in your eternal light. Mighty and eternal God,
hear our prayer.
O God, who in the Word made flesh has revealed the fullness of his mercy and grace, open our minds so that we may know you more fully. Open our eyes to more clearly see your work around us. And open our hearts to receive the gift of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice unto God.
Thank you. Peter, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and his Son to take our nature upon him. Bless you in this holy season, scatter the darkness of sin, and brighten your heart with the light of his holiness. Amen. Amen. May God, who sent his angels to proclaim the good news of the Savior's birth, fill you